Get ready to match the stars from The Price is Right. Bob Barker, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Ava Gabor, Richard Dawson, and Joyce Buellafont as we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 77. And now, here's the star of Match Game 77, Gene Rayburn.
Thank you, friends, for joining us. And first off, I greet you and thank you for... Oh, you're a beautiful bunch. You really look quite adorable.
Well, we're getting ready for Monday.
Oh, I see.
That's right.
Monday's a big day.
Monday is a big day.
This is the last day we will be on in the afternoon. Beginning this coming Monday. Beginning this coming Monday, we'll be on at 11 a.m. in the East and 10 a.m. in the West and Midwest. We will follow Bob Barker and The Price is Right. They'll be on from 10 to 11. We'll be on from 11 to 11:30 in the East and vice versa in the West. And we hope all of you who are able to watch in the afternoon will be able to watch in the morning, because we know it's going to be down.
We're going to miss them.
Let's say hello to two beautiful ladies, Susie Mallett and Susan Wilson. Now, Susie Mallett's a current champ. She's won one game and has $100. And she's being challenged by Susan Wilson here, who has had her first round question and is ready for her second round question, right?
Yes.
She's a theater major.
A theater arts major, Cal
Where?
State Long Beach.
Cal State Long Beach, yes.
Cal State Long Beach.
Okay, ladies, good luck to both of you. The score at this moment, at the beginning of round two, is 2-0 in favor of Susie Mallett here, and we'll see how this game ends after we see about this. Now let's finish this game, see how round two goes. Susan Wilson, you may have A or B.
Okay, I'll choose A this time.
A it is. A is as follows. Little Muggsy is the toughest kid in his school. When he entered the pass, punt, and kick competition, he didn't use a football. Instead, he passed, punted, and kicked his blank. Toughest kid in his school.
Yes.
Now, you know what the pass, punt, and kick competition is? They have
no.
That at halftime during football games.
Yes.
You get a whole bunch of little kids out there, and they say which one can pass it the furthest,
and
kick
punt it,
and punt it, and all that. So,
can I read that while you enlighten our listeners with all that?
I have it. Now, I have that. Now, once you... But see, sweetheart, it's an imperative that you understand what pass, punt, and kick is.
Yes.
Whatever.
When in doubt, drop back and punt. Okay. Now, Susan, Little Muggsy's the toughest kid in his school. When he entered the pass, punt, and kick competition, he didn't use a football. You know what pass, punt, and kick competition is?
Right, yes.
He didn't use a football. Instead, he passed, punted, and kicked his blank.
His teacher?
His teacher.
Yes.
Teacher, eh? Are you a teacher?
No.
No, you're not. Bob, what'd you say?
Well, I thought he was having trouble with his brother.
His brother.
Brother.
Passed, punted, and kicked his brother.
There's no reason to boo that.
No. It's not a bad answer.
It's a good answer.
It's not a bad answer at all.
I'll tell you when to boo.
Yes, right.
I figure his bloody teacher would be smart enough to stay off the field.
Right.
So he kicked his little pass, punted, and
kicked his
sister.
Yes. He could easily intimidate
Now you may boo.
Cool it.
You tell him, fat lady. Oh, pardon me, I'm sorry. Turn on the people
you
who say
you. Tell them when to boo and not boo on your own show.
On Price is Right.
On this show, I tell them when to boo.
When is Price is Right going to be on?
Price is Right will be on at 10 o'clock Eastern Time, 9 o'clock Western Time, beginning this coming Monday.
A half hour earlier than
then
you.
We'll be on
right.
at 11 o'clock.
What will be following
will be,
Price
following.
Is Right?
The Match Game 77 will be following us, won't it?
Yeah.
Okay. Now, so far we've had brother and sister.
I never heard such a... Well, all right.
Teacher.
Teacher is one. One for Susan. She's looking for a teacher, Ava.
Well, all I can say, she's got one. A teacher.
Another teacher. Good for her. When he entered the pass, punt, and kick competition, he didn't use a football. Instead, he passed, punted, and kicked his teacher.
Oh, happy day.
Oh! We're up to three now. Susan, show us your teacher, Joyce.
I'm a
gonna have a teacher.
Do what I tell you to,
Well, he couldn't pass if he did that to his teacher.
Oh.
I said his kid brother.
Kid brother. Okay, brother, sister, teacher, all good responses. So you picked up three there now. Susie, one to tie, two to win. Scores 3-2. The rabbit said, woe is me. I had an accident with a porcupine. Now it hurts when I blank. You don't write, darling.
I know.
And neither do you.
Do I write?
You do. The upper tier writes, along with Richard.
The upper tier is me. I haven't been too sharp this week.
This week?
The upper tier is really kind of faded away.
All right, here we go, Susie. The rabbit said, woe is me. I had an accident with a porcupine, and now it hurts when I blank.
Hop.
Yeah! Hop.
Hop. Hippity hop.
Hippity hop. You have a whistle around your neck.
Yes.
What is that for?
It's a rape whistle. You blow it if in case of attack.
Oh, no kidding.
It's for my mother.
That's to call all the men?
Yes. Yes. No, wrong.
Oh. No, it's hop.
Okay. What do you say, Bob? She's looking for the answer. Cop.
No, hop. Hippity hop.
Now, wait a minute, folks. Wait a minute. We got a guy here who's supposed to keep track of stuff because I can't keep track of everything, and he wrote cop. They're fired.
Gene, that's not just a guy. That's Roger Dobkowitz. He works on our show, too.
That's right.
What does that say?
You notice there's never a hop around when you want one.
That's right. Never a hop around when you need one. What did you say?
Now, it's been so long, I just want to be reminded that the answer was hop.
Woe is me, I had an accident with a porcupine, now it hurts when I hop.
And the answer was hop.
Right.
And what she wants is hop.
Right.
And what I have is hop.
Huh.
Hop.
Okay. Tie score 3-3.
Oh, sweetheart, he could hop his little buns off. It was only when he tried to make rabbits that he got his
That's what hurts. Another hop will win the game for Susan. What
Fred
do you say?
Fred had a rape whistle.
Yes?
And it rusted. Hop.
Hop wins the game. And the rest of you have. Okay. Come on down, Susan. Sorry, my microphone is just, the cable is hung up. There, now it's all loosened up there, and there you are. You just hang around there for a second or so. Susan, you missed it by one or two. It was a pleasure to meet you. Good
nice
luck to you.
Nice meeting you. I had a very nice time.
Thank you, Susan
Bye-bye.
Wilson. Goodbye, Bye. My dear. While we're sitting here off, we want to spend a little message of commercial interest for you. Here we are with Susie Mallett. Who's won her second game? She now has $200. You're doing it the hard way, Susie.
Sure am.
You ready to have a go at the big money now?
I'll try again.
Gonna get the smarts now? Get some ESP and empathy flowing to the panel there?
I'm gonna share.
Here we go. We polled a studio audience not too long ago. We said, you write down your best answer to this. Blank spell. Now, the answer they gave most often will get you $500 if you match it. If you match the second most popular answer they wrote down, you'll get $250. And then for matching the third, you get $100. And you'll get some help from our celebrities.
Richard.
A magic spell.
Magic spell is one answer.
Joyce.
Oh, I have two things.
You have two things? I hope you have two things. What else is new?
Thanks for noticing. Dear, which one's best?
Go along.
Which one?
Well, I can't see the deal.
This one. This one.
Under my spell.
Under my spell.
Under my spell.
Okay. You don't have to sing, just a simple little answer is all we ask.
And Brett.
Godspell.
Godspell. Godspell, famous rock musical that's been running around for years and years.
We've seen it 8 times.
You have?
Yes.
So those are the three, Godspell, Magic Spell, and Under My Spell. You may choose one of those or give us one of your own.
I'm going to go with Magic Spell.
Magic Spell. You seem so enthusiastic about Godspell.
I know. I just don't think that many people have seen it.
Really? Okay. She wants Magic Spell. Let's find out if it's up there, and if so, where. We'll begin at the bottom as we usually do and reveal the $100 response. Magic Spell, you got it right off the bat.
Right off the bat.
Now let's see what's under the $250 response.
Witch's
spell. Dry spell is under the big one?
Oh, that's a good one. I like that. Yeah.
What? You don't know. You are not speaking as one voice there. Cool it.
Oil spell.
Oil spell.
Can you look who's correcting me?
Avis
says spell.
May we see it, please?
God. I'm ashamed of myself.
Once a year.
Really.
You really thought of it and you...
Oh, that was the first thing that came to my mind.
You violated the basic rule here. Say the first thing that comes to your mind.
Oh.
Oh, well, anyway. You've won something and you're going to play for 10 times that amount now, or $1,000, and that isn't bad now, Susie. You can collect it if you'll match one celebrity.
Of course, Richard. I'd love to kiss him.
What's that?
Another one to love to kiss him.
Yes. Okay.
I already gave.
That's it. That's it.
Come on, let's. I want to get some money here.
All right. Good luck to you anyway. Here we go. Property blank. That's P-R-O-P-E-R-T-Y blank. Property blank.
Property.
Property, yes. Susie, what answer would you like to give us that'll match his in this case? Property blank.
What's been going up and up? Taxes.
Property taxes. Indeed, they are going up and up and up, aren't they? Okay. She says property taxes will match a Richard.
I was thinking in the other area. Settlement. Oh,
yeah. Settlement.
Yeah.
Are you having some troubles, Richard?
No, I had mine in 62.
Oh, I see. It's all over now.
Yeah.
You've settled, have you? Have. Well, now, Susie, you're going to meet another player now. You've picked up another $100 there. You got a total of $300. So let's welcome your new challenger, Joan Ellison. You know this lady, don't you?
I sure do.
Hi. Joan, we welcome you and ask you to tell us a little bit about yourself, if you would, please.
All right. I can be very short and succinct. I'm from San Diego, California.
Aren't we all?
Aren't we all. And I note read for court reporters, stenotype note reading.
Yeah.
And this is the second biggest thrill of my life.
Really? What was the first biggest thrill of your life?
Marrying my husband.
Oh, that's nice. Well, aren't you trying to say that?
That's the truth.
All right. Well, I'm glad it's a big event for you. It's a big event for us to have you here.
Thank
Joan,
you, sir.
Good luck to you. We'll ask you to begin by making a selection of A or B.
Oh, I think I'll take B, please.
B it is. New game, and this is it. Harry said to the psychiatrist.
Yeah.
He says, Doc, you've got to help me. My wife thinks she's a horse. All night long, she kept blanking. My wife thinks she's a horse. All night long, she kept blanking. Very easy.
Sure.
It's very easy. You think she's a horse.
I get it. I'm just hanging around.
You say the Price is Right is moving up
yes.
A half hour earlier.
The Price is Right is going to be on at 10 o'clock in the east instead of 9:30. It's going to be on at 9 o'clock out here. No, 10 o'clock. I think it's moving time, yes.
No, it's 10 o'clock,
10
in,
o'clock
the east,
in the east,
9 o'clock,
9
in, the
o'clock in the west. And did you know that by coincidence, this show is changing time too?
That's right. Match Game 77 will be on at 11 o'clock in the east and 10 o'clock in the west. And we hope all of you who are watching at this moment will watch us then in the morning too. Please, just get up. Hello there. Oh, hello there, Joan Ellison. It's up to you now to give us a response to this. Harry said to the psychiatrist, Doc, you've got to help me. My wife thinks she's a horse. All night long, she kept blanking.
Whinnying.
Yeah! Whinnying.
Neighing. Whinnying.
Now, say it again.
Whinnying.
Yeah.
It's a difficult word to say.
Yes. Now, what else did you say?
Neighing.
Is that the same? Is whinnying and neighing the same thing?
They're the same, I believe.
You said whinnying or neighing.
They're the same.
They go,
They are the same, and it occurred to me, but I thought she'd say kicking.
Oh, kicking.
You know why?
Horses do, that's right. That's right. Kicking is good, too. All right.
I thought of neighing, and then you said it's an easy question, and I thought, oh. And I went with kicking, which was an error. I should trust myself more.
Right. I agree.
Not necessarily, though, in the long run.
Show us your whinny, Charlie.
Continuing in the great tradition of the Rockettes, kicking.
So we have three kickers on the upper tier. She's looking for winning or neighing, Ava.
Well, I was galloping.
Galloping.
A horse gallops.
Yeah, but in bed all night? What?
She's Hungarian.
It's a big bear.
Interesting.
Darling, you must learn the English language.
No, I really got the giggles.
Harry said to the psychiatrist, "Doc, you've got to help me. My wife thinks she's a horse. All night long, she kept neighing."
Yeah, well, he'd say, "Would you like a little love?" And she was just neighing.
There's one for Joan. What about you? You got a whinny or a neigh over there?
No, I don't got a whinny or a neigh. I'm just a little bit slower than you are, Ava. I said trotting on
it. Oh, terrific. Oh, splendid. So there we are. That's your first round question, Joan, and now you see how it goes. And we'll have one for you, but first we've got this for you. Here we go. Other half of round one. Susie, this is yours. A round one-er. Sally said, "I'll never have dinner with Richard Dawson again."
Why?
She what? Said she'd never tell.
Well, she did. She said, "The last time I did, he made me blank." Never have dinner with Richard Dawson again. Last time I did, he made me blank.
Hello, Kim. Is that all right?
It's wonderful. I can't read it. Just put it in the
you
slot.
You need a
we'll
translator.
That's it. Okay. Susie, Sally said, "I'll never have dinner with Richard Dawson again. The last time I did, he made me blank."
Throw up. I'm sorry, Richard. Made me sick.
Really?
Well, yeah. Boy, she said she wouldn't have dinner with
me. One head-to-head match, they really turn on you, don't they?
That still happens.
Wow, yeah. I get property settlement. She said property taxes.
Yeah, I can attest to the fact that he's not a bad cook at all. I've had dinner at his house. Yes.
You didn't throw up?
No. Not at all. It was wonderful. What'd you say?
Well, I've known Richard for many years.
Yes.
And had dinner with him on many occasions, and he would never make you throw up, but he would make you pay.
Yeah. Pay the bill.
Pay.
El Cheapo is what he's referring to. What do you say?
Actually, Sally was what we call a mercy dinner. You know what a mercy dinner is.
I do know what a mercy dinner is.
So he said you pick up the check, huh?
I see. All right, so far we have two of those. Charles?
Pay.
Three of those. Well, the truth is coming out. Susie, what do you say?
Susie? My name.
Susie's already said. Ava, what do you say?
Oh, I thought I changed my name.
No. Would you like to change your name?
I would. Well, after what I wrote down, I sure would. I said, "Made love to me."
I see. I asked him, and he made me make a lover to me.
When did you actually...
We just could have ended it right there. What?
Just a little while ago, I saw Sally.
If you see Sally, tell her that I love her. What do you say there? Tell us the truth, Richard.
The truth, yeah.
You were there.
I cooked her dinner.
You cooked her dinner?
And I made her wash the dishes.
That's it. All right. Here we go. Thanks. Last chance for barfing.
I beg your pardon. I said foot the bill.
Foot the bill.
Foot the bill.
Well... And that, you would have scored with a lot of those there. So there's the end of round one. Scores 1-0. Favor the challenger. Round two will follow round one. But first, this. We have to hold everything right here and put you in cold storage for a little while. And until we meet again. Y'all will show up on Monday morning, right?
Oh, yeah.
Don't forget, we're changing our time. Don't forget, folks. This is the last time we'll be on in the afternoons, beginning Monday. This coming Monday, we'll be on 11 o'clock. Eastern time in the east and 10 o'clock in the west, in the AM, and 10 o'clock also in the Midwest. We will be following Bob Barker and his troupe of folk there on The Price is Right. His show will be on a little half hour earlier to accommodate us. Now, the next
time. Is that why we're doing it?
That's right. The next time we get together, these are the bodies you will see on this stage.
Nipsey Russell, Brett Summers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Sarah Purcell, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Keen Raven, join us next time, Match Game 77, Monday morning. Bye.